Just having breakfast with a new friend. Nah, I'm not eating. Let's leave Miss Piggy to her breakfast.
Crazy hooker life.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Catfish Casino. Today we have a special game with an even more special guest waiting for us.
My guest today shares a common interest with me, music. Both of us used to be video jockeys for TV channels. Now, she's a celebrity, actress, and a model. Her name is Pitta.
Sawasdee krap.
Sawasdee ka. Okay, let me play like that.
Then, like, right? Game ni mi chua catfish roulette.
How do we play it?
We spin the wheel, and depending on what number it lands on, that is how long your ideal fish is going to be in centimeters. So, the aim is to catch the fish that is closest to the number that it lands on within 1 hour. Ladies and gentlemen, let's roll.
Wait, Ben.
Whoa, 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 90 centimeters.
Okay, I'm ready.
And did I mention, we have a croupier.
Ah.
Khapunkap.
Khapunkap.
Let's roll. คิดว่าเจมส์วอนมาทำอย่างนี้ก่อนมันออกภารกิจไหม
นั่นดิไม่เห็นคนแถวนี้ทำเลย
คนแถวนี้ไม่ทำเลยหรอเพราะเขาไม่รู้สูตรลับ
The goal of the game is not to catch the biggest fish in the pond, but to catch the one closest to our magic number.
โอเคไหม
ดีมากเลยแหละ A plus A plus My turn to cast.
Ooh. So what, we just now sit and wait?
Yes, we do. ปกติพี่จ้าเป็นคนชอบทานอาหารแบบไหน
ตะเลียนไทยญี่ปุ่น Why are you using your hand?
ป้าได้แล้วครับป้าติดแล้วครับ
ของต้าฮะ
เอาไปไปแล้วกินข้าวไป
ข้าวเหรอ
โอเคยกยก fish on เออ
fish on ทำไงนะ
ก็แล้วก็ยกยกยกยกด้วยสองแขนเออ
Whoa! Pitta needs to use her muscles to tire out the fish before it can be reeled in.
การมาตกปลาแล้วไม่ต้องตกปลามันรู้สึกชิลไงไม่รู้อ่ะโดยเฉพาะการที่ว่าตกปลาคืออาชีพของเราอ่ะ
ยูจะตกงานเร็วๆนี
้มาเร็วก็แล้วยก
นี่ออกกำลังกายตายเลยเนี่ย It's here! พี่ทำยังไงต่อ
หม
ุ
นครับ
หมุน what?
เฮ้ยมันใหญ่ไปหน่อยเปล่าเฮ้ยต้า
เก่งปะล่ะ
ไม่เก่งเพราะต้องออก90
ต้าบอกแล้วต้องมากับดวง
so your fish is a bit too big นะปรับเมตรมาหน่อยครับปลาตัวนี้อยู่ที่132เซนติเมตรใหญ่ไปหน่อยเปล่าเธอ
บาย
เอากันแล้วเหรอ
ฮะ
fish on
I think I have a big fish, so this sucks. But it might still be a little bit smaller than hers, so fingers crossed. Fish is still pulling. That's a strong fish. See it on the surface right now. Coming right in. Kopo Chaning.
Okay, stand by.
Now, to make it fair, I will net my own fish.
No! Why are you too big?
Yeah.
Got out!
Yes! Stop me in the cup!
Uh-oh, Pitta, you're in trouble now.
What?
I have 130 centimeters!
2 cent
makes all the difference. It's your fault for always going after the big things in life. Sometimes,If you go after the small things, you just might win.
And so the Catfish Casino has come to an end. And I beat her by just 2 centimeters.
Shake it. Oh.
The longest handshake ever.
Could be longer. But wait, it wasn't, because mine's shorter and I won.
Where are you going?
No, come back. No. Hi, we're at Bang Phra Reservoir. It is about an hour's drive east of Bangkok, and today I'm going to show you some of the methods I use to catch my favorite fish species, the giant snakehead, known locally as Plachado and in Malaysia as Ikan Toman. Let's get to it. Right now I'm using my sonar to find what's underneath the water, see how deep it is, what temperature it is, and all that kind of stuff. We are at 4.2 meters. There's a lot of fish, lots of vegetation underneath as well. The vegetation actually extends over 1.5 meters above the bottom. All the fish are hanging above the vegetation, so that's good too. All the fish are hanging on the shallows. So I'm gonna start with some top waters, see what's going on. Earlier in the mornings, they'd like to hunt in the shallows, but then when the sun gets brighter, and they can go deeper to look for fish, that's when they go more towards the open water, so they won't be staying around the shallows as much. It's never easy picking the right lure to catch the fish that you want. So here are some of the main factors to consider. Sunlight plays a very important factor to choosing your lures. When there's less sunlight and less light could penetrate into the water, you want to choose something more colorful and bright, like a chartreuse colored lure, so that the fish can easily spot your lure. Another factor that you have to consider is barometric pressure. When the pressure has been steady for a long time, fish become sluggish, so I would use something like a swim bait, for example, that has a slow presentation. The next thing to consider is water color. If the water is dirty and stained, you're gonna need the visibility, so you're gonna have to use something more clear, like a chartreuse colored lure like this one. When you're looking for snakeheads, it's quite easy. They surface for air. So when you see a big ring in the water, usually that's a snakehead.
There are a lot of bubbles, but the fish aren't biting.
We've been searching around the heavy cover area for a while now, but we haven't found any good responses yet. That's fishing for you. You don't always expect to catch fish, but you always have to calculate. You always have to adjust yourself to how the fish is. And if should you win or lose, you will always have to walk out with a smile on your face because you went fishing.
The last location wasn't so good. All the grass had rotted and the water was extremely smelly. Not exactly ideal condition for fishing. So I move on to a new spot.
In fishing, if the conditions are bad, your best bet is just to leave and find somewhere better. It's quite common and it's a smart thing to do. It's no different than life. If you find yourself in a bad situation, sometimes it's just better to walk away and start fresh somewhere else. Fish on! Whoa, I got a double hookup. Holy crap, I got a double hookup. I got two fish in the same lure. Okay, now only one fish. Okay, let's lift it in. There you go, guys. This is a giant snakehead. Fishing's much better here. This one's feisty. I try to end my fights with the snakeheads nice and quick. That way they could be healthier. The faster you end the fight with the fish, the less stress it has to endure. We didn't have much success at the first location, but sometimes you just gotta move around a bit, stick with your science and what you know, and sometimes you might get a little lucky. Time to let it go.